hydraulic hose come off here or get loose on the grapple. So we're just tidying that up. We're gonna head into the pine plantation after we drop this little bit of logs off on the bunks for the mill. And we're gonna cut some more pine for our cabin. Tidy things up a little bit. Pretty cool. Looks like it fits pretty well, eh? This is what we did. Welded that drop hitch in there. It's just on a pintle. It should do the trick. I think maybe what we'll do is we'll give her a good rip today and we'll see how it is on the hills. And you think it'll pull that up the big hill? Let's give it a try. You gotta bring it in a little tighter because I can't reach that far. Little more. That's good.
Straight.
So right now we've got
to the trail.
Hey,
right to the trail.
Yeah, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna just start mowing down basically. Look how much dead stuff there is in here, right? Yeah. Well, it looks like it's going that way, so that's good for us. We're gonna start smoking them down. We'll work our way
work. We'll go to the out to the front there, and then we'll start laying them down. And then we'll come back, and if we have to, I'll push them over. And hopefully these are rotten enough that we can just drive over them.
It's that nice warm pine smell, eh? Did you notice it driving down through here? Just a beauty. You know, now that we have, it's funny, when you look, because of all the cutting we've got, all the green stuff on the side of the trail, it actually looks more alive in here than it's ever looked. Just, you know, all the dead brush.
Okay, so grab the two saws, bud, and we'll grab the wedge.
Okay, there should be another one, and we'll grab the axe.
And we'll go out there and we'll just start working it.
How many are there?
12? 11? 11, 12?
Thank you. back up a bit. Now do it to that one. Hey! Stump! Lift it up a bit.
Oh, you're good.
Back up. Hey! Lift your blade up. Hey, bud. Now come in and push this.
Nope. Yep.
Yeah, big mess.
Oh boy.
All right, so I think we've proven that our idea to try this just isn't going to work.
Too hard.
Yeah, well, it's there's logs everywhere and just a big mess. So, but I want to see, you know, I was hoping we could just push them out of the way with the skidder. I think in the winter it'd be easier. Because I can maneuver them a lot easier than on the ground.
Or if you had a wider blade.
A wider blade. Or if we cut down a whole other row or made more room. But, you know.
Or I was just thinking this earlier too. If you cut a whole row, you leave the skidder at the trailer at the end of a row. You cut a whole row down. You come in with the skidder and you move everything and then you come in with the trailer.
Yeah. I think the best way to do it is to just drop the trees, hitch them up, bring them to a common area, buck them to the length, and then grab them and go. You know, grab them with this. I mean, this thing works well. It's just fiddling around in here is just, it's, I don't think it's that good of an idea. Yeah, it's, if you could straddle the logs that you dropped, grab them from the back and put them on, but you can't do that. So I think what we'll do is, we'll go drop this load off, come back with the trailer on, drop it over in that little clearing that I made over there, and then
come in here, push everything off the side.
Push everything off to the side, because it's too hard to maneuver with that trailer on the back. Push everything off to the side. I'll skid out those other trees, and then we'll come and tidy everything up and make it all nice again. We're letting lots of light through. The growth is going to be fantastic. All right, well, let's go drop those off. See how she does. But, you know, we figured it out. And, you know, you don't know until you try, right? That's right. What a beautiful day.